Hi friends, welcome to Voice for Public Sector YouTube channel. Today we have with us Sri Ravindran, the president of Coimbatore Compressor Industries Association, MSME, micro and small medium enterprises, is facing a big threat for its existence in India today. There are around 12 crore MSME industries in India today. They are employing crores and crores of people in their industries. But in this industry, there is a threat for its existence today. And Sri Ravindran has led the strike on 20th of December. There was a massive strike. And Sri Ravindran was one among the person who led the strike in Tamil Nadu. We want to hear from him about the issues pertaining to the MSME industries. And what is the exact solution for these problems that they are facing today? Welcome, Sri Ravindran. Sir, we want to hear from you. What is the reason for the strike, one-day strike that you went yesterday, when there are a lot of announcements by the government to protect the MSME, especially in the name of credit, in the name of giving a lot of concession to MSME? What is the reason for you to go on strike?
Yesterday's agitation and that strike, actually it is only one single agenda. Yesterday's agitation is against the abnormal rise of raw material, all raw material prices which we are purchasing. All the MSMEs, you know, we use steel, copper, aluminium, rubber, plastic, even this craft paper which is used for making carton boxes. All the raw materials for the past 1 year, abnormal rise, 100% it has rise. It is totally, it is not experienced earlier. Earlier years we used to, the prices will increase, it will increase by 10% or 5%. But this time starting from last September 2020, it has gone to gigantic level. The problems are these: most of the MSMEs, they are supplying to public sectors, they are supplying to big corporates, and they are, most of them are ancillaries, they are supplying components. So the main raw material users or purchasers are only small industries and micro industries. We only purchase. The larger companies, they don't purchase the raw material. We are purchasing and making into the components or some products and supplying to other sectors. So these corporate, see, those who are supplying to railways or any public sectors, the orders are given for 1 year period. And there is no any provision or any class, price variation class, there is no any provision for increasing price. Once the contract is placed, we have to supply, and we, with the private sector also, they won't raise the price. They will tell we have booked orders with our dealers. So totally it is a loss for the MSMEs. That is the condition. So we have represented, there was no any response from the Prime Minister or from the central government. And central government is the main, they have to intervene. So, for highlighting our problem and drawing the attention of government, that we conducted one day strike. It was very successful, and we are planning further representation, or somehow we have to take this momentum until we get some sort of intervention from the government.
The MSME industries faced a bigger problem in the year 2016, when demonetization was introduced. At the time, it was said that it is only a temporary phenomena. And once the demonetization, after 50 days or 100 days, the problem will be over and the MSME will be back to the original form. But in Tamil Nadu, when the 2018 financial budget was presented, the then government said that 50,000 MSME industries were closed in Tamil Nadu alone, and nearly 5 lakh people lost their jobs. So is the effect of demonetization still lingering around, or it is over?
No, this is one after one blow. Actual blow. This is, it is continuing. Demonetization is it is a big blow, particularly for the micro industries at the lower level, because they are purchasing against cash, and very 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 small people, they were most affected by demonetization. And second thing is, GST is the next blow actually. So once they introduced the GST, earlier when the talks were going on, this the GST will be introduced. What we thought, already those who are paying excess duty as well as VAT, so you have to go to state government, and those who are paying excess duty, they have to go to central government. So instead of two windows, a single window is better. It was the opinion among the industries, so everybody welcomed that, because in VAT regime there are so many headaches, like C forms or so many things. Every state, they will have their own check post and everything. So these are the things, it will be eliminated. We thought it welcomed everybody. Everybody welcomed to GST. But the problem is, GST is somewhat comfortable or convenient or helpful only for those people who paid excise duty as well as sales tax, that is VAT. But micro sector people, those who are having turnover below 1.5 annual turnover before below 1.5 crores, they need not go to excise duty. They will be only in the VAT regime. So for them, it is no benefit at all. Instead of any benefit, the problem is now, these compliance of GST, so many forms, so many complications. It is a big tragedy for the people who already did not pay the excise duty. That is a, so this, even though GST, the government told, we are enhancing the ease of doing business, but there are some hidden agendas. That's what the hidden agendas means. They want to increase the tax collection. They want to bring more people into the tax network. They want to increase the compliance of tax paying. So all these are hidden agendas. Simultaneously, everything was forced. So with this agenda, everything, the GST process has become more complicated actually. Now even auditors are finding it very difficult to file annual return. Earlier, these people, the owner, he himself will file the annual return. Now without the help of auditors, nobody can not file annual return of GST. So GST is a very complex thing. Apart from this, there are so many headaches are in this. You can see, after introduction of GST, there are nearly 3,000 amendments. You can see, who know all these things. So simply, it is not enhancing the ease of doing business. GST is for enhancing the revenue, enhancing tax, government's tax revenue. That is the only agenda.
The government claim that earlier, prior to GST regime, the MSME industries were not paying the tax properly, and they were not registering their industries also in a proper manner. Only after the GST was introduced, the MSME industries are paying the tax, and moreover, they are not in a loss because they are getting ITC, that is input tax credit, they are getting back. Once they pay the amount, and they are getting back. So there is no problem for them, and they are in fact very comfortable with this GST regime. Is it true?
No, it is one-sided argument actually. See, most of the GST, there is GST in GST itself allows, you need not register if your turnover is below 40 lakhs per annum. if you are a product manufacturer, if you are doing only supply of goods, up to 40 lakhs turnover, you need not register. And if you are providing only the service, up to 20 lakhs rupees per annum, you need not register things. So most of the people, you can see in the MSMEs category, 95% are in the micro sector. Even if you take that 95%, 75% will be below taxable pay limit only. The GST itself, they have admitted 95% are below 1 crore turnover. So how the tax will come? Revenue will not come from these people. Actually, they are not cheating the government. Simply, they are below the taxable limit and no any tax. Actually, ITC, you cannot take it. You cannot see now 18% ITC they are paying. Everything is in now accounted, actually. Those who are not paying means they will use this 20 lakhs rupees slab and simply they don't get registered. And that is the thing. Most of the things, if we are not paying the tax means, what we are purchasing the essential raw materials, they will be coming only with the VAT or this or any excise duty, everything. So if they are not coming into the account means they are losing that input credit. So actually there is no any loss. My point is those majority of the people, 75% of the people are below the taxable limit. So there is no question of any revenue from this sector. And the next 20% is below 1 crore. And their tax paying capacity is also very less.
Coimbatore was called as the Manchester of South India. Now we hear that a lot of industries are being closed in Coimbatore because of this GST, demonetization, and other issues. And many people are opting out of MSME industries today. What is the situation in Coimbatore today?
Actually, people are now scared actually to enter into engineering industries. This is not a recent phenomenon. Recent over 10 years, this is happening. No many people are not interested in investing in engineering industries or manufacturing industries particularly. And that is the real situation. Even investments are not coming. They are finding out manufacturing, the profit has gone down actually. So the problem is when Mr. Modi ji, he came into power, on September 25th, 2014, he announced a scheme. Actually, the first scheme he made is that is Make in India, he announced. So during that year 2014, share of manufacturing sector to GDP, it was around 17%. So in all other countries, developing countries like this China, South Korea, Thailand, this manufacturing sector's share in the GDP is around 30%. In our country, it was during the 2014, it was only 17%. So for our country with huge population and infrastructure and everything, strengthening the manufacturing sector is alone. That is the only way to develop our economy. So Modi ji rightly, he pointed that and he set a goal to achieve 25%. This manufacturing sector should achieve 25% in the share of GDP by year 2022. And he also announced by year 2022, we will create 10 crore new jobs. This was the announcement. But what happened after this demonetization, GST, one after one, this manufacturing sector, it is dwindling actually. Now the statistics is on for the year 2020, the manufacturing sector's share in the GDP has diminished to 14.43. That is government's figures. And second thing is this trade deficit. It is increasing. Last year trade deficit, international trade deficit is 7.5 lakh crores. There is no any improvement on that. And even last year, this India received 6 lakh crores foreign direct investment, FDI. The most of this amount, 6 lakh crores, it went to only the software or cell phone manufacturing or computer hardware manufacturing. To hardcore manufacturing sector, very little amount of foreign direct investment was received. And most another thing is this McKinsey report, it says from the year 2016 to 2020, for the 4 years, the rate of return from the manufacturing sector is less than the rate of the cost of funds, that is cost of borrowed funds. What does it mean? Actually, we are getting from bank at 12% interest or 10% return. But our rate of return, our profit is less than that. So we are earning something and paying only the interest to the banks. Nothing is in our hand. It has been clearly told. And last year, 2020, 1 crore jobs are lost. Instead of Modi told 10 crore jobs will be created, but last year 1 crore jobs were lost. So profit is dwindling. And another main point is the salary index. Salary index data for manufacturing sector last year, during the last 4 years, it has come down in manufacturing sector 16% decreased. So how people will come when other sectors are paying more, construction sector or some other sector, service sector? That's why there are big rush to join Zomato or Swiggy, but people are not coming to manufacturing industry. So salary index says 16% salary is reduced in manufacturing sector. So investments are not coming, and actually rate of return is low, and salaries are going down, and skilled workers will not come. Another pathetic scene is skilled workforce in India is only 4.7%. But whereas in China, it is 24%. In Korea, it is up to 96%. In Japan, it is 80%. In US also, it is around 75%. But here, it is only 4.7% skilled workforce. What for the past 6 years, 7 years, what the government has done? This is the scenario. So without the support, without the growth, without the development of MSMEs, how you will create 10 crore jobs? That we are asking. That also when we are suffering with the abnormal raw material price rise and everything, there is no any single word from the government. So that's why investments are diminishing, and people are actually, they are all panicked to come to manufacturing sector.
When you speak, it creates a sense of fear for me, because what will be the future of the country? The lot of slogans were, when this government assumed power, lot of slogans were made. Digital India, Skill India, Make in India. But when you give the statistics, I'm really wondering what happened to those slogans. What is your future plans there? How do you try to overcome this problem? How do you plan to carry forward your movement? Yesterday was a very successful strike. How do you plan to carry forward this movement further?
Yes. Actually, this government actually starting from that Make in India, they have come out with almost 10 schemes actually, not one scheme. 10 schemes, that is Make in India, then Skill India, and Shram Smidha, and labor reforms policy, national manufacturing policy, and defense procurement policy and this Mudra scheme, PMMY, Mudra Yojana, and Stand Up India, and Startup India, and then Stand Up India, and finally Atmanirbhar, that is for. So all these things are empty slogans, actually. Actually, the real crux of the problem is rate of return is low in the manufacturing sector. That has to be boosted. So, see, I have clearly told, we are earning less than what we borrow. Our rate is, bank rate is 10%, 12%. And government, they took some drastic step, at least for 10 years, they should, MSMEs, they should pay, at least pay, they should give loan at 2% interest. So when we are paying only 2% rent, then our rate of returns will go up. Now what we are doing is, we are just earning and paying to interest, paying EMIs, that's all. And another thing is, as you have told, this real estate, previously when I started the business, actually some 1 lakh rupees or 2 lakhs rupees, I can build a construct workshop, or with some 50,000 rupees, I can borrow some one ground of land like that. Now you cannot imagine, the simple building will cost into crores. So all this investment cost has increased. Government cannot do anything to bring down the real estate prices now. Now only thing they can do is at least to subsidize this bank loan interest to 2%. That is, you take a bold decision, you subsidize. For 10 years, you, for all the MSMEs, you give at some 2% interest, or say 4% interest. Banks may charge some 10%, that gap, that should be subsidized by the government. They should not put the thing on the banks, because then they will lose. Then these senior citizens, this fixed deposit rate will come. That they should not do. Banks will charge the normal interest, but government should subsidize. That's one thing they should take, at least for one decade. They should boldly announce, they should give. Let them give, let them see it, what the progress. So investment will rise. And second thing is, those who are paying that GST regularly, promptly, they will be given some reward, at least some 2% rebate or 2% interest subsidy, something they should be given. Like some bold decisions they do. So we cannot go out. The only progress for our economy is to strengthen our manufacturing sector. That is the only way out. There is no second way. But they should really take some bold decisions and do it. Otherwise, these manufacturing sectors will be slowly wiped out, and we will be doing some services. That is more, that service sector means it is more uncertainties. See, now our service sector, our computer sector, IT sectors, they are thriving only because we know some English. What will happen? Some other countries also capture it. So the business will go there. Already it happens. See, in textile sectors, Bangladesh, they are capturing more orders. It is a known fact. And being very new to the market, they directly go into some advanced techniques. They can do it and start from there. So depending on the international business, it's not a good proposition. We should strengthen our own manufacturing team. That is the only way out. For that, the government, definitely they should do, and to increase the rate of return from in the manufacturing sector, that they should address first. And all sorts of concessions they should give. Let them take it for 10 years. So many things. That is my strong opinion. My point is, was the decision taken by the government to strengthen the manufacturing sector or this 25%, that is correct. but actually they have not implemented, and just they have announced, I think they have forgot, gone into so many other things. But this is high time, and strengthening the manufacturing sector is the only way out. Otherwise, our country cannot improve. Our country is not a small country like Maldives or like that. See, Maldives actually, their GDP or this per capita income is almost some 3 to 4 times than ours. Very small country. They can thrive on tourism or something, or more like Mauritius. That Mauritius Island with all foreign funds and these illegal funds, they can thrive on. But our country is not in that scenario. That is totally not suitable. Our is a huge population. Already there is some industries are there. Basic infrastructures are there. So only thing is we should strengthen our manufacturing sector. But that is a very huge task. Already we are far behind from Korea, Indonesia, China, Thailand. They have advanced very well in so many sectors. So the government should take very bold decision to all these things. Another main thing is already I have highlighted. See, we are spending only 0.7% for 0.7% of our GDP for research and development R&D. Our R&D expense is 0.7%. Actually, this China, they are spending around 2.3%, and international average is somewhere around 1.8% of their GDP. China, they are spending 2.4, and very high GDP spent on by Israel. That is 4.8% of their GDP they are spending on R&D. Israel and also Germany like countries, they are spending more. But our country is still spending only 0.7% in R&D expenses. These are all the melody. These things are not improving. Then this manufacturing sector, how it will improve?
Sir, thank you very much for coming to our program. In fact, it will be definitely useful for the people at large. And we also stand benefited by your speech and by your interview. And we think, we hope the government will take into consideration the points that you have raised in this interview. And I hope some remedial measures will come in the future, or you will be intensifying your program to bring the government down, like what the farmers did in the Delhi borders. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your participation.
Right, sir.